I have lived in a CCRC, which is shorthand for Continued Care Retirement Community, for more than 7 years. It's a beautiful, well-tended cluster of buildings and acreage with friendly residents and activities galore. Early on, I found a niche that suited me. I joined an in-house newsletter and eventually began writing a column for each issue about what it's like to be the age we are. I write about the pains and gains of life in the slow lane, as I see it. It was all infinitely interesting and touching to me, and this collection is the result. Among the astonishments in my life, like the price of a Milky Way or using a computer, is that I'm 88 years old and writing another book. I say another book, since I have many of them out there, only at the other end of the spectrum. Once upon a time, I was an established children's book writer. My audience used to be the young, from picture book age on up. Now, my audience is their grandparents on up. I moved here due to the ill health of my husband, and because keeping up a big house was no longer possible. The first thing my old friends wanted to know was, what's it like? Meaning, what's it like to dismantle your house, get rid of your possessions, leave behind the familiar, and go live in a retirement home? It was too complicated to explain. Mostly, I remember feeling as if I had landed on another planet. Instead of being surrounded by the noise and tumult of ordinary street life, I was in the quiet country of the retired. It took some getting used to. For instance, it was the dining hall that threw me at first. If you have ever gone to a new school as a child, there is a whiff of similarity. Take away the years, the wrinkles, and the arthritis, and once again, I was that shy child. Instead of a classroom, the dining hall was a sea of gray-headed oldsters, everyone seeming to know everyone else. I wanted to hang back, run home. Not yet, not yet. I wasn't ready for it. Well, times change, and I did too. In a small community like the one I'm in, you just can't hang back unless you dig in your heels and are determined to be unhappy. I found myself in the company of people who had interesting careers and odd and various personalities, with tales to tell that had enough drama to stock a soap opera. There's no magic guide to get you through the challenges of aging. Humor is a tremendous help, and fellowship will get you through a lot of grief. Throw in money, health, and luck, and you have a recipe for a good old age. That's a pretty tall order, and not many of us have it all. Yet, whether we have the recipe or not, we are all fellow travelers. It's a rough ride, but it's a bountiful world, and we have the immense gift of still being part of it. So, let's enjoy what we can while we can, and to hell with the rest. I have tried to put the humor and the difficulties into these reflections, and I dearly hope they will find in the wider world some nods of recognition.